The next mission to an icy moon, whether it be Europa or Enceladus, should have a microscope of some kind. And we're trying to define the parameters of such a microscope that will maximize our ability to see life on Earth, because if we can maximize our ability to see life in all the possible extreme environments on Earth, then we can be pretty confident we can come as close as possible to being able to address this one other planet. Enceladus has raised a lot of recent interest. It is a small moon of Saturn where there is a clear liquid water ocean under a sheet of ice, and through this ice there are these geysers or plumes that are emitting material up into space where they can be sampled and captured by flybys. So it makes it a whole lot easier to go to a moon where you can sample by simply flying through the plumes rather than having to land. We really want to know if there are microorganisms living in this global ocean. We believe that there's not enough energy to allow for multicellular life, so we're talking about bacteria. And we would hope that there would be intact cells in the plumes, possibly even living cells in the plumes of Enceladus. There are many things you'd have to do in order to see whether there are living bacteria in the plumes of Enceladus. First of all, these plumes are really no thicker than the smog in Los Angeles. So you're going to have to fly through probably 12 to 20 times in order to collect a femtoliter of liquid. If you're flying through, you're probably flying through at 1 to 5 kilometers per second. So anything you capture either is going to have to be decelerated or is going to be pretty much pulverized. So we're trying to develop a bunch of capture techniques and capture substrates that would maximize the return from any sort of Enceladus flyby. Given all of those constraints, how would you know if there are bacteria there? I think it's going to take a variety of techniques. We're going to start with imaging, but if you think about your ordinary bright field microscope, the biggest drawback about it is that you have to have an expert observer there sitting there getting the precise focus to see bacteria. And so you can imagine that if you're out on Saturn with the 1 hour light speed delay, you're not going to be able to be twiddling the knobs getting a focus. So holographic microscopy is an interferometric technique, and what's good about it is that it's volumetric, so you don't have to focus. It captures an entire volume in a single hologram, and then with software techniques you can reconstruct what you see on each focal plane. So to test out some of these techniques, we've been going to so-called analog sites on Earth, essentially to ask ourselves the question, if we go anywhere at all on Earth, no matter how cold, how dry, and we take up a random sample and stick it in our instrument, are we going to see life there? And are we going to be able to tell that it's life? In 2015, in the spring, we went to Nuuk, Greenland, and sites around there. We looked actually in the sea ice. When we go to these extreme environments, most of the time we have no idea what we're going to see. But what is cool is that we always see bacteria and we always see life. So we're very interested in that, for not just for Enceladus, but also Europa and any of these icy moons of Jupiter and Saturn. How many bacteria do you need to see in an ocean in order to be confident that this is really an ecosystem? And that's the question we don't have an answer to, really.